introduces us to a phenomenal African woman who paved the way for her descendants to enjoy generations down the line by thriving in what was considered before a male-dominated world. Katherine Johnson, Dorothy, and Mary Jackson are the three African-American women through whose mathematical efforts astronaut John Glenn launched in orbit. But picture this, yeah? African-American in a STEM field that is oozing male testosterone. It must have been frustrating. Or if you watch Hidden Figures, you will notice it was frustrating. But when these women got to NASA, their aim was not to whine about the frustrations, but to prove one thing and one thing alone. What a man can do, a woman can do better, anytime, any day. So this speech is for you who is a freedom fighter. This speech is for you if you are gifted, but for the longest time have waited for somebody to hand you the opportunity on a silver platter. Listen here, lady. This is a man-eat-man society. Nobody will give you that chance. But today, we forget about the thorn in our flesh. We forget about the prevalence of men in STEM fields. And we forget about the discrimination that women face in these fields because they do not even make a third of the workforce. Instead, as civilized, educated, enlightened, and visionary freedom fighters, we go back to the drawing board and ask ourselves, what can we do about it? So first, we stop crying and whining about it and we create awareness for STEM opportunities that can be provided for women. Second, we encroach these spaces. We make ourselves sit on those tables. And if the tables are full, we do not pull our seats in and squeeze ourselves next to them. No, we create our goddamn tables. And three, for the women who are already in these spaces, we make way and pave way for upcoming women in STEM fields. Listen. Women, we have realized where the problem is. The STEM gap will only be reduced if we stop talking and start working. Like legendary Miguna Miguna says, mobilize, organize, viva. Ladies, let us increase our representation in STEM spaces so that we can have progressive realization of women empowerment. Thank you.